Hello everyone, in this video we have one circle and one square, and then this side is given 4 and here is given 6, and these are given as attention points, and then yellow circle area is asked. First up, let's call here center of circle, and then let's draw perpendicular. These are 90 degrees, right? Because of tangent. And then I want to represent with R radius of the circle. So here must be equal R unit, and this length is also R unit, right? Okay. And then notice that let's call here theta. That means this arc must be equal to theta. So here must be equal theta, right? Why? Because theta is a tangent chord angle, right? Okay. And then we know that these two sides are parallel because of square. That means if here is theta, this angle must be equal theta. And then notice that if here is theta, this angle is also theta. That means we get an isosceles triangle. Right? Therefore, these two sides must be equal. And then this side must be equal to others. Why? Because of two tangent theorem. And then if we extend here, like this, let's call here point K. If you notice that, we get a butterfly, right? Okay. That means ratio of these two sides, 4 over 6, must be equal ratio of these two sides. And ratio of these two sides is also equal 4 over 6. So 2 over 3. And then this length, let's call here 2x. That means here must be equal 3x, right? Because of butterfly. And then we know that these three parts are equal. So these are 2x. And we know that a square has four same sides. That means if this side's equal 2x plus r, that means 2x left here, right? If here is 2x, here is 2x, that means x unit left here. Okay. And then we know that this triangle is also an isosceles triangle, right? That means this sides must be equal 3x. And then if you focus on this biggest triangle, we can apply Pythagorean theorem, right? So 2x plus r whole squared plus this side, 3x plus r whole squared equal 5x whole squared. Right? Okay. So 4x squared plus 4xr plus r squared plus 9x squared plus 6xr plus r squared equal 25x squared. And then 4x squared plus 9x squared equal 13x squared, and r squared, 2r squared, 4xr and 6xr plus 10xr equal 25x squared, right? If you move these terms right side of the equation, that means 12x squared minus 10xr minus 2 r squared equals 0. And then if you divide by 2 both sides of the equation, we get 6 squared minus 5xr minus r squared equals 0, right? And then let's factorize the equation. So 6x plus r times x minus r equals 0, right? That means x equals r, and we know that x can't be negative, so cancel that. That means x equals r. Or you can think like this, let me delete here. You know that 3 squared plus 4 squared equals 5 squared, right? That means 3x whole squared plus 4x whole squared must be equal 5x whole squared. If you notice that x must be equal r. Okay. Let's write here 2r, and then if we extend here, we get a right triangle. So if here is 2r, that means this length must be equal to r, and if here is r, that means this length must be equal r unit, right? And if x equal r, that means this length 2x must be equal to r, so r unit left here. And now for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, r squared plus 2r whole squared equal 10 squared. So 10 r squared equals 100, that means r squared equal 10. Therefore, yellow circle area equal pi r squared. So we know that r squared equal 10, that means area equal 10 pi, and we know that pi equal 3.14, that means the area equal 31.4 unit squared. Thanks for watching, and if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.